Hello everyone and welcome to episode 5 of SAP Tech Byte series on ABAP CoData Services. Today we are going to discuss about unit tests in ABAP CoData Services using CDS Test Double Framework. As you all might have experienced, we create multiple CDS views in our applications and it is crucial to make sure that each of them function correctly and produce the expected results. But there is a challenge in performing the unit test of CDS views due to its code pushdown feature. Since the logic in a CDS entity is executed in the underlying database, independent of the ABAP runtime, it is not possible to use conventional ABAP solutions for inserting dependencies. So here, the dependent on components, DOC, are usually read-only, which makes it difficult to insert test data into these components while testing. This is where we can use CDS Test Double Framework to address these challenges. CDS Test Double Framework enables you to test the logic expressed in CDS entities in an automated way by creating updatable test doubles for each dependent component in the same database schema. The framework double that is created will have the same structure as the original dependent component. Some points to be noted here are: the dependent on database tables are copied without data or without any primary key constraints. Also, the database tables created for dependent on database views has the same structure as the dependent on database views. The implementation of the function double is modified to be able to insert the desired test data into the double. The framework is also creating a clone or a copy of the CDS view under test CUT in the same database schema. Here, the actual logic in the CDS view to be tested is preserved and only the actual dependent entities of the CDS view to be tested are replaced by the corresponding doubles that are created above. One important point to note here is that not every CDS view requires to be tested. Unit tests should be implemented for views which contain some measure of logic, and this logic can be some kind of calculations or filter conditions. Some examples can be expressions involving conversions, Boolean expressions, and we already mentioned about calculations. It can be a select statement with complex where conditions, or it can also be used to verify the join behavior of a CDS entity. Another important point to note here is that unit tests should not be used to test the properties of CDS entities, which can be better tested using static checks or integration tests. And this means it should not be used to test simple projection views or maybe some naming conventions. Tests which are based on the CDS Test Double Framework are not suitable for performance tests. So I hope all of you got a better idea about what is CDS ABAP test units. And now we are ready to create a test class and enhance a view with some calculation logic. So for this demo, we are creating a unit test for a CDS view involving a logic to calculate 10% discount on the actual price if it is above 1000 in the respective currency. And the final result will be available in the field price after discount. So now let's move into the system and write this logic in the CDS view and also create the CDS test class and execute and see the results. Okay, so for the demo, we'll be considering the CDS data model carrier view. So we'll be writing a case statement to identify whether the price is greater than or equal to 1000. And if it is greater than 1000, we'll be providing a 10% discount. Okay, so let's add the case statement. Case when price is less than or equal to 1000, or price is initial, then we are returning the same value. Otherwise, in the else condition, we'll be providing the 10% discount and we'll be subtracting it from the existing value. Okay, so now let's close this case statement. Okay, so the case statement is complete. Let us also add the annotation for currency code. Okay, so after that, our view is ready to be activated. Let's activate the view. Okay, so once the view is activated, let's go to the Project Explorer and select the CDS view that we have added the logic. Right click on it and select New ABAP Test Class. So this will open a new window and you can provide the name for the test class and provide a description also. Click on Next. And here, please make sure that you are selecting the test type as unit test and you're also selecting the dependency for creating the double. There's no need to provide a name for the test method. So you can click Next and click on Finish to create the ABAP test class. Okay, so the ABAP test class is now created. Let's quickly have a look. So here you can find an expression, the rate testing DMOI flight hour. So this denotes that this particular test class is created to test the CDS view DMOI flight hour. Okay, and we can also see something like duration short. This indicates that usually the code is relatively small for unit test. So that's why it is mentioned as duration short. Risk level harmless means that using this test class, we are not trying to change any persistent data or system setting, and that's why the risk level is harmless. So in the private section, you can also see a reference variable environment, which is referring to the test double framework. So this variable is used to create the test environment and also the test double of the database table that the CDS view is selecting data from. And here again, you can see some fixture methods like class setup, which is used to create the test environment and the test double for the database table that the CDS view will be selecting data from. Class teardown is used to destroy or delete the test environment and the test double after the test class execution is complete. Then we also have something called setup, and this is used to clear the test double and the test environment before each execution so that there is no interference with the results from the previous test. And we also have some method called AUnit for CDS method, which is used to select the data that is required for testing. Okay, so in addition to these methods, we'll also create four new methods: above threshold, below threshold, initial value, and equal to threshold. These methods are used to identify whether the logic we have written in the CDS view is working as expected or not. So let's declare them. Okay, so we have now created all the four methods that are required for testing. And here you can also click and create the implementation methods. So now the implementation methods are also created. So let us write the logic to fetch the data. So declare a variable flight mock data. Okay, now the next step would be to pass the data to this flight mock data variable. And because it is above threshold method, we'll be passing the value 1500. Okay, and after that, we'll be inserting this value to the environment. Insert test data. The next step is to select the price with discount value. Okay, and then result is stored in act_result. And then finally, we'll be passing this data using the class CNABAP unit assert. And the method that we'll be using is assert equals. So here, actual value equal to whatever we have received in act result. Then expected value after 10% discount is 1450, and the message will be price with discount. Okay, so the logic for above threshold is complete. So let us copy this particular code and use it in all the other methods. So in the below threshold, we'll be passing the value 500 because it has to be below 1000. And in the equal to threshold, we'll be passing 1000. And initial value. We'll be passing 0. Okay, so now the coding is complete. And let's activate the class. Okay, so the class is now active. So let us now check whether the test class is working and providing the results as expected. So for that, select the test class, right click, select run as, and select again ABAP unit test. So the ABAP test class has got executed, and we can see a summary here that there are no errors. If there are errors, there will be a blue cross mark, and for all the success messages, we have green tick mark. So you can see here that all the methods have been successfully executed. So you can also see a negative test scenario. So for that, let us do one thing. Let us pass 1000 for initial value. Let's activate the class. So the expectation is that the initial value method will throw an error because we are expecting the result as 0, and what we are getting back is 1000. Let us execute again, run as ABAP unit test. Okay, so here now you can see that there is one failure or one error with a blue cross mark. And there are four successful executions. So in the initial value where we have an error, we can see that the expected value is 0, but the actual value that we pass is 1000. So that's why it is resulting in an error. Okay, so with that, we are at the end of today's episode on ABAP CDS test unit. I hope all of you liked it and also will surely try it out and let us know in the comments below. We'll be back very soon with another episode of SAP Tech Bytes next week. So till then, take care and happy learning.